4,000. Have you seen the amount of force these people use to us on the streets? Is it worth 4,000 shillings? If you're a cop and you're listening to this, I need you to ask yourself, is 4,000 shillings worth brutalizing your brothers and sisters for on the streets? Remember, again, there's this propaganda of this silly disease that's being touted called Mpox. If, by my analysis, it just feels as though they want to make it look like COVID. You've seen the photos of the boy looking all ugly, but it feels as though they want to impose a lockdown so that what was he undermine it, so that there's no public gatherings, because they've just dissipated it as propaganda. And this is what we said, this aura for aura business should not cease, because Babu, the government needs to be reminded that they do not own monopoly of propaganda. They might have monopoly of violence, but they do not have monopoly of propaganda. Remember, your Mpox is, it doesn't, to me, doesn't even sound like a real disease. In a sound kama kitu imekuwa fabricated, it sounds like a sponsored ad, because at your patient zero got it while traveling from Uganda to Rwanda through Kenya. It does not make any sense. For me, it just seems like it's a lockdown thing. Kumbuka, weka asira yako juu. How many bodies have shown up at city so far? The last time I saw the report, it was 240 something. So it means one body for every constituency. Kwa hapa, you've sat down as a Kenyan, bado unajiuliza why should I go for maandamano? It is for these people who are dying like dogs. Those people, I attended this Tomboya show and they mentioned the names. And I remember being so moved and standing, because there are people who laid their lives so that we can get this far. Remember, your local politician produces nothing. But sisi tuko hapa Twitter, tunatuka nana, tunasema, oh, sijui nani has done this. While the revolution is going on, we need to have one common enemy. Our common enemy is a con man, he's a looter, he's a killer and a murderer, and hires on corruption and cronyism. There, it is very true, and I'm very sad to admit that there are people who have made money off of the revolution. There are people who've received funding from organizations in the name of mobilizing people, and they have not used that money for the collective. These people, we will not let them lose. That's one thing I need to assure them. And ever since I knew, nilikuwa nafikiria kila mtu anakuja hiki tu na roho safi, but watu tu wako mchezo wa town. Ever since I knew, we said these people will have to be brought to the book. However, as long as they are still furthering this agenda, we have to figure that nane nane thing, because I'm not hearing enough of us talking about this nane nane thing. Remember, when this embittered Nairobi, currently Nairobi-based outgoing president is touring around, these trips still cost millions. It's just that we're not seeing the books, nobody's auditing it. I think, and I would wager, they cost just as much as his international trips would cost. He's now gone on a very, very rampant campaign trail, and we are letting this thing slide while having this infighting. Nane nane is coming up. You've seen the way people wanateseka. Umesikia vile artists wanadharauliwa huku nje. Umesikia vile watu wanadhulumiwa huku nje. Women are still getting raped in those informal settlements or slums. Men are still being shot like dogs. People in the slums are still going hungry. But watu wamekaa hapa chini in a chamber, in a parliament of baboons, where people sit down, interview each other as a round table chama. It's capture harvest. They go and just pick from public coffers as though they are taking an unsecured loan from a SACCO. Now, wewe umekaa hapo, hasira yako inapungua. Unakaa chini, you have the guts to think you can question the movement. You think that we will get another moment where we will give this system shock therapy like this. It's never going to happen if we don't follow through with it. You've seen the effects it has all across Africa. So ukijaribu kuacha hiyo hasira yako ishuke, nitakukumbusha net worth ya our CSs. Unakaa hivi chini, ukumbuke you are a peasant, you are a pauper. That's why you're in this space. If you had anything, you would not be on this space. Even the people who we think have money who are on this space, they have nothing. They're trying to gather more information on how best they can screw you. Now, wewe bado unakaa chini, you think you have moral high ground to call out what this movement is. Let's not accept to be sucked into the useless, these baseless infightings. Because as Ayn Rand said in 1957, when you see that in order to produce, you need to obtain permission from men who produce nothing. When you see that money is flowing to those who deal, not in goods but in favors. When you see that men get richer by graft and by pull than by work, and your laws don't protect you against them, but protect them against you. When you see corruption being rewarded and honesty becoming a self-sacrifice, you may know that your society is doomed. Alafu bado kuna watu wanakuuliza after Ruto, what next? We have figured out that society is doomed and we are trying to reclaim it. And if you just, you think about whatever even this CS vetting process is, it's like someone who's doing a colonoscopy where they're supposed to be examining your internal organs, but they're doing it with a telescope. Nobody is up for accountability anymore. And the more we let these people slide, the more we let them deem and whore our future around, we will not have a country. This thing which people are lying and deceiving you that we don't have a country, people are trying to let the country descend into chaos, is nothing. Because when you say Ruto must go, and I want to explain this to you very clearly, if you're listening to the sound of my voice, when you say Ruto must go, you are affirming the position of the Constitution. Because on September 21st, 2020, CJ Emeritus David Maraga advised the then President Uhuru to dissolve Parliament because it was not in good standing. Years later, this Parliament, as it sits, is unconstitutional. So all this rigmarole of what comes next, there will be no power vacuum. Let nobody lie to you that the country will descend into chaos, because we are peaceful, beyond being tribeless, leaderless, and fearless. We are also not, as I keep on saying, we're protesters, not rioters and looters. Nobody should lie to you that the country will descend into chaos, because what the president knows very well, if you read the Constitution, you cannot also litigate that matter of Supreme Court, the president of the judiciary has said something, now you want to litigate it in High Court. It is not a matter of litigation. You just follow the Constitution. The president knows once he dissolves Bunge, we have to go into a general election. And by effect, that means that he has resigned. So when you say, don't be afraid.
Hello?
Nobody lied to you. Can you hear me? Yes, I can. Let me wrap it up. Let nobody lie to you that the people are not for you. God is for us, the people are for us. And I talk as a person, nimeingia ground. Nimefanya kitu online, nimeingia ground, and everybody is ripe for these things. Toka hapo nje asira ikiwa juu, ongea na mama mboga wako. And don't talk down on these people. These people are equally as wise. They're equally as wise as we are. So in all our contributions and everything that you're doing, as we soldier up to nane nane, ask yourself, is this country currently working for you? And is this the kind of country you want to live in? Thanks, Amerix.
Thank you very much, Kasmueli. Yes, push it beyond online into offline. Okayo, I just want to inform you that this space has been reported several times. So when you try to fetch it, you may not see it. Jama wanajaribu ku report left, right, and center. I don't know what you have done. We are citizens. We have a right to assemble and talk. That is our constitutional mandate to do that. So, Okayo, where are you? There was a young man, Okayo, who is pushing civic education. Sisi kama bado tuko hapa ex tunagombana, huko inje there are people doing something. They are talking to mama mboga, to whatever, boda boda, kwa matatu, everywhere. They are talking. They are telling them, look, this is why we are agitated. This is why we are not happy. This is why things are not going the way they are supposed to go. People need to be empowered with information. And that's what they are doing out there. But since Yapa X, what are we doing? Insulting each other, demeaning each other, belittling each other, abusing each other. Something that we need to stop. We need to hold each other accountable, yes, but let us be in unity. Polo.
Yes, sir.
Endelea.
Hey, hata nimepoteza ni. Where was I saying? I was talking about. I mean, my core reason why I'm here is to talk about minerals and also, you know, the impunity. But my business right now is about minerals. I was saying Jimmy Wanjigi should be here, and also I saw Steve Mbogo speaking about the same issue. I think it was on Spice FM. Maybe she also tells us, maybe he forgot to mention, is it true that you have a mining site in Kenya and another one in Tanzania? Is that true, Steve Mbogo?
I saw Steve Mbogo here. The space has been having issues.
I think I can also see.
Steve Ndogo, are you here? I saw you. He was in the speaker's panel.
Yeah, he's a speaker. So
he... Maybe as we wait for Steve Ndogo, we have Ruben, Papa Ruben. I started listening to Papa Ruben back in when I was still a small fellow. Joey Bringers on VOK. Papa Ruben.
Thank you very much, Americ. I was getting worried because I have another meeting lined up, but thank you for, let me just use a few minutes. First of all, I wish we had time to talk about what MC Njagi is going through, because that's a whole issue that I have so much data.